Hi everyone, today we will do legal dictation of the Supreme Court of India part 2. The link of part 1 is also given in description box. So ready? Start. Sansar Chand, the appellant before us, has a long history of such criminal activities starting with a 1974 arrest for 680 skins including tigers, leopards and others. In the subsequent years, the appellant and his gang has established a complex interlinking smuggling network to satisfy the demand for tiger and leopard parts and skins outside India's borders, particularly to China. It is alleged that the appellant and his gang are accused in 57 wildlife cases between 1974 and 2005. Sansar Chand, the appellant herein, has a long history of involvement with wildlife crime. A brief account of the same is given below. In a seizure dated 11-9-1974, having criminal case number 23, Sansar was held guilty by the court of Sri H.P. Sharma, ACMM, Delhi on 1-8-1981 and sentenced on 3-8-1981 to rigorous imprisonment for 1 year and 6 months. This court void its judgment dated 13-5-1994 ordered the release of Sansar Chand on the ground that he was a juvenile on the date of the offence and his sentence be considered to have undergone. In another seizure dated 2011-1974, he was held guilty and sentenced to pay a fine of ₹20,000. The third conviction of Sansar Chand was by the Special Railways Court void its order dated 24-2004, which was pleased to award Sansar Chand rigorous imprisonment for 5 years. The said judgment has been subsequently affirmed by the Session Court on 19-10-2006 and the High Court of Rajasthan void its order dated 10-12-2008 against which the Sansar Chand has preferred this special leave petition. In addition to the above, there are other cases pending against the appellant which provide details of his pending cases in various courts and which were admitted by him in his statement under section 313 CRPC and which are X, P46 and P47. These exhibits shows the extent of involvement of Sansar Chand in wildlife crime. In order to highlight the extent of the organized nature of wildlife crimes being committed by the appellant, it is important to mention here that it is not just Sansar Chand but other members of his family and association who are also involved in the illegal trade in wildlife. It is alleged that the appellant's younger brother Narayan Chand is mentioned in FIR number 82-2005 Kamla Market Police Station, New Delhi, involving the seizure of inter alia 2 tiger skin, 38 leopard skin and 1 snow leopard skin and has been named as an accused in the complaint filed under section 55 of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. In this case, Narayan Chand is also an accused in the court case number 1145-2009 being tried before the additional chief judicial magistrate Haldwani arising from the preliminary offence report number 13 Fatehpur 2008-2009 involving the seizure of one tiger skin and a tiger skeleton. Sansar Chand's wife Rani and son Akash are accused in the case arising from FIR number 362-2004 Manang Chowk Police Station Jaipur involving the seizure of leopard paw and claws. CBI in the year 2005 invoked MCOCA against Sansar Chand and his family members and associates, which case is pending in the trial court in a Delhi court. The present case is only one of the cases in which the appellant has been accused. The facts of the case have been set out in detail in the judgment of the High Court, and hence we are not repeating the same here. Briefly stated, on January 5, 2003, the police arrested one Balwan who was traveling in a train with a carton containing leopard's skin. During investigation, the said Balwan on January 7, 2003 made a disclosure statement to the SHO GRP Bhilwara that the two leopard skins were to be handed over to Sansar Chand at Sadar Bazar, Delhi. The appellant was charged, seated, and after trial he was convicted by the additional chief judicial magistrate Railways Ajmer, Rajasthan by his judgment dated 29/4/2004. The appellant filed an appeal which was dismissed by the special judge SC/ST Prevention of Arcosities Cases Ajmer, while his judgment dated 19/8/2006. Thereafter, the appellant filed a revision petition which was dismissed by the Rajasthan High Court by the impugned judgment dated 10/12/2008. Hence, this appeal. Thus, all the courts below have found the appellant guilty of the offences charged. Learned counsel for the appellant submitted that the prosecution case is solely based on the extrajudicial confession made by co-accused Balwan White XP33. We do not agree apart from the extrajudicial confession of Balwan. There is a lot of other corroborative material on record which establish the appellant's guilty. It must be mentioned that persons like the appellant are the head of a gang of criminals who do illegal trade in wildlife. They themselves do not do poaching, but they hire person to do the actual work of poaching. Thus, a person like the appellant herein remains behind the scene, and for this reason, it is not always possible to get direct evidence against him. In the courts below, the prosecution filed a list of pending cases against Sansar Chand, in some of which he has been found guilty and punished. The appellant has been prosecuted by the Wildlife Department in various courts, as mentioned in the letter of the Deputy Inspector General of Police, CBI, New Delhi, to the Inspector General of Police, Jaipur, dated October 20, 2004. XP33, which contains the confession of the appellant, was written by PW11 Arvind Kumar on the instruction given by accused Balwan while in custody prior to X-33. Balwan has also disclosed the name of appellant Wide XP6 on January 6, 2003.